Hi, this is Zuri Berry of the Boston Globe and Boston.com, and with me is Boston Globe Patriots beat writer Shalice Mansa-Young, and we're here at Gillette Stadium for the conclusion of the NFL draft. Now, the Patriots picked up Southern Miss linebacker Jamie Collins first and foremost at number 52 overall. First, Shalice, I want to ask you, why a linebacker first when everybody knew they needed a receiver, and what's the deal with that? I mean, what's your take on him?
Well, you know, the Patriots did end up getting a couple of receivers this weekend, but Bill Belichick is always going to do what he wants to do, what the best value is. We heard that word yet again on draft weekend. We heard the word value 15, 20 times maybe when it was talked about with Bill Belichick, with Nick Caserio about this draft. You know, Collins is a kid, he had a really interesting path throughout college. He came in as a safety, got moved to linebacker as a sophomore, played outside linebacker in a 3-4 system as a junior, and then last year, as they went 0-12, he was a defensive end in a 4-man line. So this guy, versatility, there's another word we hear a lot from Bill Belichick. He obviously is versatile. A league source told me on Friday night that he might be almost a big safety kind of guy. He might even have that much flexibility to be a safety, maybe a guy that they're looking at to cover tight ends. We know that that's something they struggled with last year, the last couple of years.
Coverage linebacker, that came up quite a bit. The other thing, they came right back at number 59 and did go with the wide receiver. They got the Marshall wide receiver, Aaron Dobson, 6'3", 210, 211. Great 40 time. What is your take on him?
He's fast. That's certainly, he has the size. He's fast. Bill Belichick said something interesting, I think, that he said the receivers they selected, they also took Josh Bryce on Saturday. He said they were both smart. He said they were both mature.
Tell him something and then see a play a few plays later and say, well, you know, what would you do on this play if they did this, if they did that? Well, that's what you talked about previously. And so, you know, there's different ways to measure it and all that, but I think he's a pretty impressive kid. He's a mature kid. He's pretty smart.
That mature thing sticks out to me because we all know how much trouble they've had drafting receivers over the last decade plus. You know, you look at guys like Bethel Johnson, you look at Chad Jackson, you look at even Taylor Price. Those guys weren't the most mature guys. I think, you know, this is something maybe they've recognized the pattern. They're trying to change their fortunes and get some young receivers in here that they can draft and develop because they haven't been able to do that in such a long time. You know, I think he's a little raw. Dobson's a little raw, but there's a lot of promise there. If he's as smart as Belichick believes he is, if he can pick up things with Tom Brady, hopefully he changes the pattern that they've established.
All right, one of the other themes of the night was that the Patriots picked up three Rutgers players. It was like Devin McCourty was an assistant GM there. Just looking back real quick, they have Justin Francis. They had Tequan Underwood. They had Alex Silvestro. They've got all these Rutgers connections now. What's the deal, and why does Bill Belichick favor Rutgers players so much?
Well, we know the relationship that he has with Greg Schiano. He obviously likes how Schiano developed players. McCourty has worked out. Francis had a pretty good rookie year. He was an undrafted guy, so clearly his best days are probably in front of him. You know, it's funny to me because Belichick clearly likes, you know, those Schiano-bred players at Rutgers, but then this is Schiano's second draft in Tampa Bay, and he hasn't taken any of his former players. So it's a little interesting to me there, that dynamic of why, you know, Schiano's not taking his own guys, because he obviously knows better than anybody what they can do.
Okay. And the last question I think we all want to sort of get an understanding right away, and this goes to our reactionary nature just in itself, but what kind of grade do you think you would give the Patriots right now?
I'm terrible at grading. You know, I'm a firm believer that it takes – really 3 years before you can look at a full draft class and get a good idea, you know, was it a stronger draft? Was it not a great draft? This is one of those drafts that I think a lot of these guys are picks for maybe 1 or 2 years down the road. And interestingly enough, you know, Robert Kraft sort of hinted at that on Thursday night at the team draft party. He did talk to reporters and he said, you know, I think probably only a couple of guys would get a chance to make a really big impact as rookies. So he even gave a little bit of foreshadowing there. They might all be, perhaps Dobson would be maybe the guy that you think might get the chance to really be an impactful player right away. Again, if he can get on the same page with Brady, if he understands the offense. But maybe a little bit more of, you know, maybe later this year, maybe next year is when we see these guys really start to get their chances.
Okay, the Patriots with 7 draft picks this year. That should do it from us from Gillette Stadium. I'm Zuri Berry for Shalice Mansa-Young. We'll see you later.